All right, beautiful day here in Bethel Park. Welcome to the Farmer's Market. Chuck, why don't you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about what the Farmer's Market is.
I'm Chuck Stover. I'm the Recreation Director. The Farmer's Market is, we have two farmers here and different vendors, food vendors and whatnot for the people of Bethel Park and the surrounding communities to enjoy. The market was started in 2006 at the Community Center parking lot.
Okay. You got a great crowd today. Is this a normal turnout for you?
Yes, today is. Since we moved up to St. Thomas this year, this is a normal crowd.
Okay. All the vendors pretty happy with it then?
The vendors are very happy with it.
Okay. What can we expect to find when we walk around today?
Fresh fruits and vegetables, kettle corn, different types of chicken and barbecue, pierogies, different types of pies, loafers, bread. Spring House is here from 84 PA.
You said you have a couple of the farmers. What are the farms that are here?
Kearns Farms and Simmons Farms.
And are they bringing, this is July, so corn and everything?
Corn and everything is now in.
Okay, when they come earlier in the season, are they here every week of the farmers market?
Yes, the farmers are here every week.
Okay, and when does this run to, from when to when?
This starts the first Tuesday in May and ends the last Tuesday in September.
And this is every Tuesday, and what time of day is it?
Every Tuesday from 3 to 7 p.m.
Okay, and where are we at here?
St. Thomas More Church, the corner of Fort Couch Road and Oxford Drive.
Okay, thank you very much. We're going to enjoy walking around and talking to your vendors.
Thanks.
Welcome to the Farmer's Market here in Bethel Park. Can you introduce yourself?
I'm Jake Simmons. I work for Simmons Farm. We sell a bunch of produce like corn, tomatoes, zucchini, cucumbers, basically anything that we can grow in the Peters Township. That's where our farm is over in Peters Township.
So when we say Farmer's Market, by a true sense, that's why Simmons Farm is here.
Yes.
You guys have been in existence for how long?
My grandfather worked on the farm, my father worked on the farm, now me, and I'm pretty sure it goes back generations after that. I do know we haven't always been in the same place, but it's been in our farm for a real long time.
How long have you been part of the Bethel Park Farmers Market?
We've been here quite a few years. Yeah, because this is the first year it's here at this church. Before it was at the rec center, and I know we've done that for years.
Do you like this new location?
I do. I really think it's gets a lot more people here.
And this is July now, so you ought to have a pretty full booth. What do you have in your grocery store, let's say, today? What are you selling?
We got peaches, nectarines, strawberries, blueberries, cherries, corn, tomatoes, zucchinis, peppers, cucumbers, lettuce, broccoli, beets, and much more.
So just about anything you could think of from a farm, you're in full force now.
Yep.
And how long will you have this much produce?
We should have it for at least a month or two, and then once we get near fall season, we'll mainly have like apples and pumpkins, but we'll still have some of this stuff too. So,
okay. Well, we're glad Simmons Farm is part of the Farmers Market.
Yep.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Thank you.
Go ahead, introduce yourself.
Yeah, my name is Bill Fontana, Fontana Pasta. Corporate name is Calafonte Foods. We're out of Vandegrift, PA, about an hour away. And we're at the farmer's market to spread our good products around.
What are some of your products?
We have 8 kind of ravioli, 4 kind of gnocchi, a couple stuffed shells, a lot of frozen filled items.
Do you do well at the farmer's market?
We do okay some days no, because of the weather that we've been having this year.
Okay. How long have you been doing Bethel's farmer's market?
The Bethel Market, about 6 years. I think this is our 6th year here. We've been doing farmers markets for about 8.
You like up here at St. Thomas more compared to where it was?
Yeah, you know what? There's a lot more traffic, obviously, but a lot of the customers that we had down at the other place, at the community center, I don't think are coming up.
Well, that's what we're trying to do, to make sure everyone knows where you are and what the farmer market is.
Well, that's great. We really appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So how about introducing yourself?
Hi, my name is Robin Londino. I have a jewelry business called Robin Londino Jewelry.
Very nice.
And I've been in business 15 years in the South Hills. do a lot of craft shows. This is my first farmer's market, though.
How long have you been doing this farmer's market? For all year since the beginning?
Yeah, since the beginning.
Do you like it?
I love it. Yeah, it's great. And the location's wonderful, right across from the village, right at St. Thomas More.
Okay, so you have good clientele, people coming for the produce. You're next to Simmons Farm.
Yes.
You got a pretty nice spot here.
I do.
So do you spend more at Simmons Farm than you make here at the jewelry?
No. I try not to.
Okay. But it has to be fun next to all the
It's great. And I make the rounds every week.
You have beautiful jewelry, though.
A lot of good things. I have a lot of sterling silver, but good prices. I even have things under $10, so hope everyone comes and checks it out. All right.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
All right, why don't you introduce yourself, who you are, and what you do here.
My name is Michael Becker. I'm here for Tim Wu's Hawaiian Shaved Ice, and I've been a vendor here, I think, at the Bethel Market now 4 years probably. So we just basically have shaved ice. We have over 30 different unique and exotic flavors, along with all the classics, blue raspberry and cherry. And it's really a good market, honestly. Bunch of different vendors here. You could get anything you really want as far as produce, and it's all fresh. So it's a very nice place.
Excellent. Thank you. Welcome to the Farmer's Market here at Bethel Park. And how about introducing yourself and what your company is?
Hi, I'm Carissa Lute, and I'm here with Logan Family Farms. We raise all-natural, dry-aged beef, and we bring all of our cuts with us, and we sell them here at the market.
You have premium, natural, dried-aged beef. Can you tell us what makes for a good piece of meat like this?
So we let it hang in a cooler for 21 to 30 days after the animal's been harvested, and it breaks down the muscle naturally to make it more tender and to make it have a better flavor. It's what the old-time butchers used to do back in the day when food actually tasted good. So it's a lot different than what you're buying out of the grocery store.
Is there a way from looking at your piece or a cut of meat, a normal person can tell a better grade from a grocery store grade?
Generally, you're going to look for the marbling. The more marbling, the better piece of meat it is.
Can you show us what the marbling is?
Of course. And you can see all of the marbling, which is like the fat that runs through it. When you cook it, that all melts out and gives the piece of meat flavor.
Anything else you want to tell us about your family farm?
We're all natural, and we don't use any hormones, steroids, or antibiotics. So come check us out.
So why don't you introduce yourself, tell us about your company, and what you're doing here at the farmer's market.
All right. My name's Dory Lynch, and our company is Hillside Goat Dairy. It started roughly 5 years ago as the result of a 4-H project that my daughters had and has evolved into the soap and lotion. We really enjoy coming to the Bethel Park Farmers Market. We love interacting with the people. Our customers are wonderful, and it's just a pleasure to be able to be here.
So this started as a 4-H project by these two?
Yeah.
And what's your names?
My name's Hannah.
My name's Mandy.
And tell us about your 4-H project. That sounds very interesting.
We milk the goats, and all their milk goes into the soap and stuff, so it's fun. I like it. And
who thought of the idea of turning it into selling products?
Probably our dad and our mom. And yeah, well, we all agreed, and we all have fun doing it, so it was fun, yeah.
How about introducing yourself? Tell us why you shop here at the Bethel Parks Farmers Market.
Hi, I'm Lisa Jenkins. This is my husband, Jim.
Hi, Andy.
We started coming here the first Tuesday it was here. We've been here every Tuesday. I love the selection of everything, all the different foods, excellent sauces, raviolis. We get the ribs and the barbecue every week. We've tried the halushki and the pierogies. We love Kevin Kern's fresh eggs. We get here early to make sure we get our eggs. We usually eat a gyro while we're walking around, and we've bought some steaks and ground meat from the local meat farm, and we love supporting all the local farms and local businesses and the independent businesses. We love this new location here. It's very convenient, much more room, more parking. So we love all the food. I don't cook as much every week because I take a lot home, and it works out great.
So you pretty much shop here every week, every Tuesday?
Every Tuesday, I'm here, yeah.
We've been here every Tuesday for a month or better.
Yeah.
Maybe six, I don't know, as many weeks as
And now that Simmons has their corn here, it's the best corn I've had so far.
It's July. Corn is ready. That's it.
Excellent. It's great. Yep.
Wonderful. Thank you for stopping by and saying hi.
It was good talking to you, Andy. Thanks for doing this, helping the independent businesses as always.
Always.
We appreciate that.
Thank you. Hi, and welcome to Bethel Park's Farmers Market. Why don't you tell us who you are and about your company?
Hi, my name's Sarah. I'm from The Pampered Chef. Basically, what we're doing here today is just trying to get people encouraged to cook more and host shows and everything else. We have a lot of great stuff today that we're showing off, and I have a few cash and carry items. And then I brought my little assistant, Anna, here.
Hi, Anna.
All right.
Do you do well with the farmer's market? How long have you been participating in this one?
Actually, I split it up with two of my coworkers, so we all alternate different weeks. Whenever I'm here, I do pretty well, so I can't really complain.
Very good.
Thank you.
Hi, welcome to the farmer's market.
How you doing? Good.
Could you give us your name and your company?
Sure can. My name's Steve Kingsland. I'm a Bethel Park resident here, and the name of my company is Rowdy Barbecue, which is located in Brentwood.
Okay, and what do you do here at farmer's market?
This farmer's market, we offer barbecue pulled pork, beef brisket, barbecue pulled chicken, some sides, ribs, great mac and cheese, all to go, to eat now, whatever is easiest for the guests.
Okay, and you come every week?
Every Tuesday.
Okay, wonderful. Have you done the farmer's market for a few years?
This is our first year at this farmer's market here in Bethel Park. They asked us to be involved last year at the end of the season, and it's great. We're really enjoying it. We also do another one on Mondays at Cassie Village, our neighbors over in Whitehall.
So. Okay, wonderful. Thank you for being part of it, and we'll get some dinner.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
All right. Hi, welcome to the farmer's market. What can you tell us about yourself?
Hi, I'm Jeff Keener from Keener's Just Nuts. We sell cinnamon glazed nuts, salsa, and ice cold drinks here at the Bethel Farmer's Market.
How long have you been doing this?
We've been doing the Bethel Market for 5 years now.
Okay. You happy with them?
Yes, yeah, it's a nice market, yeah. New location this year. The crowd's starting to pick up a little bit more.
You're getting used to the new locations.
Getting used to the new location and the traffic and the parking. No more rain. No. It's always a rainy Tuesday, but we still come out and have a good time and celebrate the community and it's a community I grew up in.
What's one of your best sellers? What do you do the most of here?
Our mild mango salsa, our spicy corn guacamole, our cinnamon glazed almonds, those are our big sells. We do about 16 different dips every week. We do about 8 different ones. We rotate them out of the 16 different dips that we do. So something new every week. Come have a sample, give us a try. You like it.
Very good. Thank you very much. Welcome to the farmer's market. What can you tell us about yourself?
My name is Amanda, and this is Andy, and our company is A519 Chocolate. We specialize in hand-painted chocolate truffles and also French macaroons.
How long have you been doing the farmer's market?
We are new to the market this year.
How's it going for you?
It's been really great. It's wonderful to meet everyone and get to introduce them to our products.
How long have you been in business?
Less than a year. We're a new company. We just moved back to Pittsburgh, but we're very excited to be sharing our chocolate with the city.
Okay, so you're going to continue being part of the farmer's market every Tuesday?
Absolutely. We'll be here every week.
Great. Thank you. So how about introducing yourself and what your company is?
I'm Olivia Davis, and I'm here with the Olive Tap, and we sell different infused balsamic vinegars and olive oils, as well as some herbs and soaps that you can use anywhere in your kitchen or in your bathroom.
I think that's a nice add-on here with the farmer's market. You got a lot of chefs that come through, don't you?
Oh, absolutely.
Everyone's a chef. You're a chef, aren't you?
I would say everyone's a chef.
There you go. So what are some of the things that you can do with the different olive oils and so forth you have?
Well, they're great for salads, as anyone could use them. You can use them for marinades, add them to soups, even just drizzle on top of any of your desserts or any entree that you have at home.
Hey, how long have you been part of Bethel Park's Farmers Market?
I have just been a part since mid-May, I would say, yeah.
Are you enjoying it so far?
I am, yeah. It's a lot of fun.
Do you have a lot of customers come up to you?
Oh, I would say so, yeah. They're often intrigued by the bottles because they often think that it's wine. And what's wine doing in a farmer's market? But even if it is olive oil, and we do have wine over at the other end of the market.
So you have a second booth here?
Not us, but
okay,
just
somebody.
The market. Yeah,
somebody
does. Else does.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite out of all your products?
I would say I love the White Reserve.
Okay.
It's a balsamic vinegar, but it's been cooked at a lower temperature, so it's a sweeter vinegar than you're used to in a dark balsamic.
Okay. Is there one that the consumers buy the most? Do you have your number one seller?
That would be our Tuscan herb with the silver top, and that's just a great one for dipping bread and sautéing vegetables or marinating anything you need.
Wonderful. How about the name of your company again?
The Olive Tap.
Okay. Wonderful. We'll see you again. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. Welcome to the farmer's market. How about introducing yourself?
Hi, my name is James Allen. The company's Wild River Kettle Corn.
and we're local from Bethel Park, and we've been in business for 14 years. We set up regularly on the weekends in the Strip District.
And what are you doing here today at the farmer's market?
I'm selling fresh popped kettle corn and cheddar cheese.
Okay. Is it a good seller for you?
Yes, real good. And fresh lemonade and a sweet tea. Okay.
How do you like the farmer's market up here, the move up to St. Thomas More?
I see about a 20% increase in business from the previous place, and the vegetables and fruits are mainly just coming out now, so I expect a lot more the remaining part of the year.
Okay, and no more rain on Tuesday, right?
No more rain on Tuesdays.
Okay. Wonderful. Thank you very much.
I am Sarah Miles. I'm a granddaughter of Bevan and Sam Miner, and they're the owners of this restaurant. We are a working dairy farm, all family-oriented. We have fresh milk that comes from our dairy cows. We bring it to the store, process it, sell it. Started as that, it expanded into a buffet-style restaurant with a sun porch, catering, a bakery, everything's from scratch. We do catering, lots of weddings and graduation parties, showers, all that kind of stuff.
Where is the Spring House?
We're in 84, right off of 519.
Okay. How far away is that from Bethel Park?
It's around 25 minutes.
Okay, so nice and close. So what makes you participate in the Bethel Park Farmers Market?
Oh, just our fresh goods from our farm.
So these are all made at the Spring House and brought here?
Yes, everything is.
Okay, these are all fresh as in today?
Yes. We have a baker that comes through the night and bakes all night for the farmers market and for the store.
Okay. How long have you been doing this farmers market?
I've been doing it since I was like 10.
That's only 1 year ago, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the farmers market does very well for you?
Yes, it is successful.
Okay. How do you like the new move up here to St. Thomas More?
I think it's good. It'll be good to be in a new area, a busy intersection, and people, once they start realizing we're here every week, I think it'll be a great success.
So if you had to tell the best thing about the Spring House, what is it? What's your number one favorite thing about it?
Chocolate milk.
Right here.
Okay. And what is that? What can you tell us about it?
We bring it right in. There's no preservatives, no hormones. It's as the freshest you'll get.
Okay. So both white and chocolate milk?
Yes. Okay.
What's your favorite?
Chocolate. Yeah.
What's your favorite out of everything you have here on the table? I mean, you have everything here. It's not just pastries or cookies.
Yeah. I love our pepperoni rolls. They're filled with pepperoni and cheese. They're really good. I love our focaccia breads. They're yummy. And then our cookies they're dangerous.
So someone could, on their way home today, they could just stop and actually pick up the whole dinner here tonight at your place?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Wonderful. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
So tell us who you are and what company you're with.
My name is Steven Zarnicki. I'm with the Pittsburgh Pierogi Truck.
Okay. And what is the pierogi truck?
Well, we are a full service food truck. We do a lot of different special events, things like this, farmers markets as well. A lot during the summer, and we do our delicious pierogi, our halushki, as well as our stuffed cabbage.
So everything is homemade, handmade?
It's not all handmade. Okay. No, I mean, especially with the pierogi, you'll be able to see that they're machine made. We sell so many a week. I just don't have time to pitch them all. Okay. I'd have, arthritic hands at this point.
Are they good?
Oh, absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. And, we have 9 different kinds available, frozen, as well as our potato and cheese available hot on this side of the truck here.
Do you have a favorite?
My favorite is sauerkraut and mushroom.
Tasting good. So someone could stop on their way home from the farmer's market and pick up dinner on their way home, right?
Absolutely.
How long have you been doing the Bethel's Farmer's Market?
This is our first year for the Bethel Park Farmer's Market. Okay. We have been at this for 11 years, though.
Okay. Are you enjoying the Bethel Park one? Is it working out for you?
Yeah, it's very nice. It's very nice.
How do you like the traffic here at St. Thomas More?
It's pretty good. There's a lot of traffic from the road here. Of course, we put out some signs too, and I hear a lot of people saying, "Well, I didn't even know it was here, but I just stopped by, saw the signs, and this is great." So, yeah.
So, what's the one thing you want to tell us about your pierogies?
Come and get them. Yeah, come and get them. They're great. Everybody loves them. We're pretty well known around the city, and it's great to be here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
How about introducing yourself and tell us a little bit about your company?
I'm Joyce from Joyce's Copper Kettle Fudge, and I've been in business for 25 years in the same place in Hayes Lincoln Place on Mifflin Road. And we manufacture fudge, and it's all gluten-free. And we supply to a lot of different businesses and corporations, and fundraising is a big part of it. And we do a lot of farmers markets and festivals.
How do you like Bethel Park's farmers market?
I've been doing it since the beginning when we were over on Park Avenue, so yes, I like it.
Do you like the change up here to St. Thomas more?
I think it's just a matter of time before it gets
here. You know, everyone's going to know about it, and they'll be stopping on the way home, we hope.
They definitely will be, yes.
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Thanks. How about giving us your name and which company you're with?
My name is Scott with Loafer's Bread Company, located in Wexford up in the North Hills. We make 12 different types of bread each and every day, and also here at the farmer's market, we got our fresh baked pies, 12 different kinds of pies also.
How long have you been part of the Bethel Park Farmer's Market?
I've been 6 years, I do believe. So we do 4 different farmer's markets here in the South Hills, and they're very good for us. So it's worth the trip down here from the North Hills.
Okay. You like the location here at St. Thomas More?
Yes, the location has been very, very good for us here. So,
do you have a bestseller that you have here today?
Of course, our cinnamon swirl bread. That's the bestseller. Everybody loves that one. That's the one we sell the most of there.
Okay. What's your favorite here?
My favorite. I sort of like them all. But I get spoiled because I get to have a slice when it first comes out of the oven each and every morning. That's about 4 a.m. in the morning when it comes out there, put some butter on there, and it's delicious.
So as a bread maker, what hours do you work a day?
Well, during the summer months, I work about 16 hours a day. So I'm there at 4 o'clock in the morning and down here until 7 o'clock at night. So
We love having you part of our farmer's market. Thank you.
We're glad to be a part of the community. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. So give us the name and your company.
My name is Dot Harvison from J&D Sellers Winery in 84 PA.
Okay, and what are you doing here at Bethel's Farmers Market?
I'm giving samples of wine and selling.
Okay. What kind of wines did you bring with you?
I have some dry red wines and some dry whites. I have sweet, semi-sweet. Pomegranates are most popular. I have that.
Okay. What's your favorite wine?
Chardonnay.
Ah, there you go. How long have you been participating with Bethel's Farmers Market?
This is our first year.
Okay. And what do you think so far, other than a few rain days on Tuesday?
If it would quit raining, it would be great.
Well,
with the rain, it's great, but yeah.
All right. Well, thank you for being part of it.
Thank you.
All right. So introduce yourself and tell us about your company.
Hi, my name is Jennifer Zebo, and I work for the Pie Place.
Okay, and Pie Place, obviously, you have some pies, but welcome to Bethel's Farmers Market. What do you tell us a little bit about the different products you have?
Absolutely. So we specialize in whole pies, and we have a variety of flavors. We also have fruit tarts and cinnamon rolls, which are a big seller, and warm pepperoni rolls are a big seller as well. We have some cookies and muffins and all kinds of goodies.
Okay. Have you been part of the farmers market here for a while?
This is my first year doing the market, but I know the Pie Place, we've been here for 2 years. This is our second year.
Okay. Do you like this farmer's market? It's doing well for you?
I love it. Yeah, there's a lot of great people and a lot of great vendors.
Excellent. So we'll continue to see you for the rest of the year here.
We'll be here through September.
Okay. What's your favorite pie?
Oh, classic apple. Have to go classic apple.
Excellent. Thank you.
Hi, my name's Danielle. I'm from Emerald Valley Artisan Cheeses. We're a local dairy farm. Our farm's in Scenery Hill, Washington County. We produce 17 different aged cheeses, all from cow's milk, and we just included 5 new cheese spreads to our line. We're here at the Bethel Park Farmers Market every Tuesday, 3 to 7. Make sure to stop by and get some excellent cheese.
So who are you?
My name is Kevin Kern.
Okay. And Kevin, what are you with?
I'm with Kern Farms.
Okay.
We're a farm out of 84 PA, right. Nottingham Township.
Okay. What can you tell us about your farm? You're more than just a traditional farm, aren't you?
Yeah, we're basically a small family farm. Everything that we grow, we sell, we pick it. So what you're buying is 100% our product.
Okay. And what did you bring with you to today? It's beginning of July. What do you have for us at the farmer's market today?
Basically, we get up every morning and pick zucchini. That's our first thing we do.
Okay.
We have summer squash, cabbage, cauliflower, peppers, and cucumbers.
Okay. And soon you're going to be adding to that?
Yeah. Every week gets a little bit better, starting with eggplant, and then soon enough there will be tomatoes, cantaloupes, watermelons, and probably within the week or so we will be picking sweet corn.
Okay, but you do something with eggs and chickens, I understand, don't you?
Yes. In the past few years, we have started to get a good layer flock together. Right now we're probably well over the 300 mark on the laying hens. In the last year also, we have been doing the broilers, which are meat chickens, and we run a few hundred at a time of those. So on and off throughout the summer, we have fresh chicken.
Okay. Now, at the farmer's market, do you have eggs for sale here?
Oh, absolutely. Yes, every day we get up, collect the eggs, wash them, package them, and they're here fresh every day.
Okay, now they sell out pretty quick, I understand, don't they? What time do you get here, and if you want eggs, what time should the people get here?
Yeah, that is true. We do sell out very quick. The best thing to do is be here as the bell rings at 3 o'clock, okay, or give me a call beforehand to make sure you reserve a dozen or two.
Okay. How can they call you beforehand? What's your phone number?
Our phone number is 724-255-6549, and we also have a Facebook page where you can look up other information on even how to get to the farm. We're not very far away from here. We also do wintertime deliveries here in Bethel Park, so if you don't have time to get to us in the summer, you can find us through the winter here too.
Okay, are you going to soon be selling the chickens though here too?
Yes, our next butcher date will be July 17th, so starting that date we should actually be in pretty good supply of roasting chickens.
Okay, so when you bring them to the farmer's market, they're live and fresh?
They are, yeah, they're not live, but they are fresh.
Okay. Good point. Okay, not live. You know, you don't want to just pick them on up and hand it across, though, do you?
No. Okay. What we try to do is we try to have a butcher date within every week or two of, of their life cycle there. So about every week or two, we butcher between about 50, 60 chickens. So you either will get them fresh on ice or they will be frozen. When we bring them, there's not much of a taste difference between fresh or frozen. Normally, in most cases, we bring them frozen to the market, or you can come pick them up fresh at the farm.
Okay. Now, are you going to run out, next Tuesday, or when you have your next butchering? Is it something that if they're not here at 3, they're not going to get a fresh chicken?
No. You'll be able to get. We'll pack enough. Okay. That they should, you'll have no problem getting the chicken.
But is there that something they could call in advance?
Absolutely.
And you could bring
them? Yeah, we'd love to. We also do have stewing hens available, which are older layers. We also have, hearts, gizzards, and livers. So if you're really into chicken, we got it all.
Okay. Is there anything else special you want to tell us about Kern's Farm?
Not really, other than basically we, small family farm. Me and my wife pretty much pick and grow everything. And our main point or focus of the farm is it's 100% our product that we grow.
Where is the farm? Can you give us the address?
Our address is 434 Valley View Road. That's in 84, Pennsylvania. And
so you're only about 15, 20 minutes away from here, right?
That's it. Yeah, about 20 minutes.
How long have you been doing Bethel Park's Farmers Market?
We started with the original market when it was at their community center, and it's almost probably going on a 10-year mark, I'd imagine, because It's been a long time.
Yeah, so it's a good market for you?
It is, yeah. It's one we look forward to.
Wonderful. So you're out here talking, and who's back here? Your wife's doing all the work?
Yes, my wife, Nicole, and our helper, John, is here today.
Hi, Nicole. Hi, John.
So they're trying to sell stuff while I'm playing around.
Thank you for your time.
Oh, no problem. Andy, thank you.
Absolutely.
Yep.